Welcome back to my channel. Very good evening to us in this video. So friends, in this way we want to see three important topics. One is regarding what has happened to Vodafone recently and why did it break this double digit mark, which is almost sustained for nearly 2 months. And second thing is regarding the fundraise, and third thing is regarding another important question which I shall share with you. So first let's see this information. And what speciality that this information is going to have is that Vodafone India is fully prepared to unveil 5th generation or 5G generation for coming days or coming years ahead. I think this is really a very good important information given by Ravinder Takkar, CEO of this company right now. And fully prepared to unveil 5th generation 5G services with ready-to technologies and IoT offering, etc., etc. So what they are trying to say is that recently when they had this 5G Congress 2021, these words were said by this company's managing director, Ravinder Takkar. Now speaking about this thing, let us move to another factor regarding the fundraise. And here is where all these things are happening here and here and here and here. Now understand here one thing, friends. What we are seeing or what we are hearing from this various news resources, I think it is going to be very crucial, because I think for the past 2 or 3 months what many media channels were saying was that Vodafone Idea is going to get such close of amount from Oaktree, Northoak, like PE firms. Now what has happened recently is that Vodafone has believed to have dealt a new set of equity based investors and private equity investors, including KKR, Carlyle Group, etc., etc., to 2 to 2.5 billion. Now, what is the main problem here, or what is not looking so much of a positive for this thing, is that both Kumar Mangalam Birla, I think the Aditya Birla Group head, as well as Vodafone Group PLC, Nikhil, or they said is that promoters are not going to infuse any more funds into this business. Now, what is going to cause an impact among investors? They will think, right, if promoters are not willing to infuse some of those funds, then why should a PE investor like us should invest the fund in Vodafone? And that is the main cause of first point of trigger to the price momentum damage. The coverage that we started at 3 rupees and which we got up to 13.8, now we are speaking again at 9.75. This is the two updates I just want to give to you. And the third important update, why is the price damage happening and whether there are any bad information other than this. According to me, or according to what I have seen recently, or recent updates, what I have seen is that Vodafone Idea, Bharti Airtel's recalculation HR case has been accepted by Supreme Court and the meeting is still carrying on. Now what I am seeing surprise here is that if both Bharti's Airtel as well as Vodafone Idea's this so-called recalculation is going to be accepted, and whether they are going to get any relief from that, it is a life-changing path for Vodafone Idea. Let us understand the simple basic calculations, and as a search point of disclaimer, I want to say this thing. The amount what I want to say right now may not be as approximate or may not be exactly the same numbers. The number may differ. Okay. So the total payment that should be paid by Vodafone Idea is total major amount what has been given by the Supreme Court is almost 58,000 crores. And the self-assessed amount of Vodafone Idea is coming nearly to the point of around 23 crores or 23,000 crores. Okay. 58,000 crores and 23,000 crores. If we reduce these two things, right, the excess AGR amount which has been converted is almost 35,000 crores. If Vodafone Idea is going to get this full amount as a relief, then if we add the per share percentage, the share price could even double from this level. But what is the main problem, or that is the main point of discussion that we should have here, is that when that is going to happen. So I basically feel that if this AGR problem is going to get solved out, and if the Vodafone Idea could get any relief from this so-called AGR re-case or re-calculation case again, what is the purpose of raising funds? Okay, you could say to pay off debts, but understand one thing. Already I think Vodafone Idea should get some GST refunds, income tax refunds, as well as almost 6,000 crores from this so-called Vodafone Group PLC as per the terms of agreement between the merger, and they have their fiber optic business which could fetch them in the range of around 10,000 to 12,000 crores. So there have been many hindrances and many point of discussion which is making very difficult thing for these companies to have or to provide a stable valuation, right? And that is the first point of fear. And second thing is still the COVID lockdown fear as well as many other points which is making the share price to go down again. So what I feel is that once these clouds are getting cleared away, I think the real valuation of Vodafone Idea, that means the double digit valuation, could be seen again by Vodafone Idea in the days coming by. Thank you friends. If you want to get more updates, then make sure you kindly hit the subscribe button as well as my Telegram channel link is in the description below. Click it and join it. Thank you friends, and once again say bye from me.